just 6 weeks ago, I was having a carpy chat on the phone with my friend Richard, putting the world to rights and just talking through all things carp fishing. One of the things we were saying is from the good old days, fishing has lost its magic somewhat. With the rise of social media and the fact that everyone's so well connected, you know everything about certain lakes, what fish they are, what size they are. It's really lost that sense of mystery that we used to strive for when we first went fishing. And then we thought, how can we capture that again? How can we really, really go out there and just do it? And that's when the conversation of Europe came up. After fishing a public lake this spring, really inspired me, knowing that there's these fish out there that not many people have really got the cojones to go out there and chase. So then it was decided, after a few messages to some of the best anglers across Europe, friends and friends of friends, we pretty much had a plan set out. We got a couple of venues in France, a few venues across Belgium, and we're even going into Holland to fish some absolutely awesome lakes. It really has come together. Currently, we're on a public lake in France. We're gonna do a night here. We've just pre-baited a canal. So we're gonna drop onto the canal tomorrow. Hopefully, we'll catch a fish either here or at the canal, but who knows? It's fishing at the end of the day. Then we're gonna head into Belgium and meet a couple of our friends, and then head into Holland. So join us along the way. Hopefully, we can bag a couple of Euro carp.
First bit of excitement for the day, Robin just dropped down and then pulled back up tight and held there. Didn't really expect it to be a carp and it wasn't. Lovely little tench, not what we're after, but get spending the rod. First fish from France, so get this little chap back. Oh, straight into the weed, not the waters.
We've just had a little visit from our friend Guard de Pêche. He was clearly happy to see us. Communicated just in French, not a single word in English, and let's be honest, why should he speak English? It's his land. We showed him the licenses. He was quite happy with that, although he said we paid too much for them and it was far too expensive because we bought them online.
30 euros for a week didn't seem too bad, but apparently it could have been
10. 10 euros, I think.
But I think we kind of got the message that he kind of knew we were night fishing.
Naughty, no night fishing.
Not meant to be. So basically, I think that's kind of the end of it on here. We're going to have a quick pack up. I think we'll shoot off down the canal. Obviously put a bit of bait in there. So
yeah, hopefully the spots will have already kicked. A few fish will be down there and this canal looks absolutely awesome. So hopefully we can catch our first Euro carp on there.
That's it, quick night on there and then
bang on,
off to Belgium.
Just had a walk up and down this stretch of canal with the Polaroids on. Looking at all the spots, you see that all the maize that we put in is completely gone. One spot in particular had a load of bream on, and a couple of young French lads decided to fish it, and one of them fell in and shouted, help, help. So we've had to run up and literally just lift him out on the high banks. Rich had to give me a hand because this guy was not getting out. Rich has got three rods out. I'm about to put my rods out, and hopefully between me and Rich, we might be able to nick a fish. We've got a single night here. We're fishing out of the car. from the photo albums, we've seen some awesome fish. They go up to about 30 pounds and there's a pretty low stock, but I tell you what, to get a picture of one fish here with this awesome structure, you'd be proper urban. And that's exactly what we want. I want one of those in my photo album. Now.
No good.
Better. Again, better. Just, well, on his last run. Well, that was right the way up the far bank, and as soon as I hooked it, I felt it come straight across the weed. Really, really strange fight. Didn't know what it was at first, really had to put some side strain on it, debating whether to run up there with a rod, but then I thought, maybe I'll give it some slack, but he's in the net, he's fair game, come on. Well, there she is, absolutely nailed, bottom lip. Just a little 20mm tip with a bit of foam, just to add some buoyancy back into the bait. And that wasn't going nowhere. As you can see, completely pristine mouth. Quite possibly never been caught before. To be honest, Rich.
Well, 24-2.
It's a shame this isn't in the day, because this is an absolutely immaculate looking kind of bronze, awesome common. It's a bit of a weird shape, but it's lovely fish. Immaculate mouth, and just one of the many awesome fish that's in these French canals. I'm so pleased to have caught this. An absolute crazy fight. I was fishing a rod quite far down the bank, right the way along the margin. So as soon as I hooked into it, it was like trying to play it against a wall. Really had to put a lot of side strain on it, and finally managed to coax it out into open water. The braided shock leader, because there's a lot of weed, that made for interesting playing of the fish, and it dumped the lead. It was a little bit scary. I thought I might lose it a couple of times, but it's come in, and France hasn't beaten us. Yes, get him. We need to be doing a more important job, dude.
What?
Get the landing yacht. Usain Bolt did 100 metres in under 10 seconds. I think I probably just hit that myself. Got to the rod and it was absolutely screaming off. I'm connected to another one. Well, who needs the gym when you can get training like that? My friend texted me with the words, canal fish never travel alone. Got another one in the net now, so I'm just gonna rig this up as quick as possible and get it out there. The light is gonna start to get really bright soon and probably they're not gonna be on the shallow spot where I've just caught this and the other one. So get this out as quick as possible and maybe nick another one. On the scales, this one has gone £21.14. Of course, not the most monstrous fish, but it's the second fish from this canal, and it's an awesome colour. It's got this chestnut brown, it's got these little starburst scales along the back. What amazing fish. But it's like 10 o'clock now, and we're getting our way to Belgium, really, so chase a few more of these canal monsters. Quality.
Just as we were getting everything ready, sorting the car out, trying to get everything ready to get back on the road again. My middle rod gave a couple of beeps and it had obviously gone through some weed, so it didn't really give it the proper indication. By the time we got to the rod, it was right up down to the left hand side of the canal, right where Callum was fishing. So we got in a bit of a tangle, to be totally honest, and it made hard work landing the fish. But we managed it eventually. Not a massive fish by any means. Lovely little dark common. Probably one that's bred on in here. But you never know, in the next few years this could be one of the real big ones that everyone's targeting, 30, 40 pounds. But at the moment, it's just a pristine little common, but most importantly, saves me blanking in France with about an hour to spare. So, let's get him back, get the car sorted, and we'll be on our way.
Car's loaded, we're ready to rock and roll. Belgium was always going to be the hardest part of this whole carp tour. We'd originally planned to, for want of a better word, just wing it. We put in the destination, we intended to go into the sat nav, and we just suddenly realised that this probably isn't going to work. We can't just turn up on a canal and do some nights, because that's probably a good way to end up in handcuffs. We decided to drop a message to a friend of a friend, and we set up a meeting with an awesome Belgium angler, and he's kind enough. I randomly text him saying, hey, I'm Callum, I know this person and this person, can you show me some places to fish? I'm pretty much going to be there in a few hours. They text back, no problem. Awesome Belgian community spirit, the whole of Europe. They're all just so willing to help. So we're heading to this guy's hometown now, and we're probably gonna do a night on the canal and get a little bit of inside knowledge of where to fish. So I'm really, really excited. This is gonna be awesome. Currently at the SO, which I know all too well. We need fuel for the car and fuel for the belly, because we haven't eaten since this morning. Because we were too busy catching fish, weren't we, Richard?
We had a couple.
We had a few.
So yeah, so, we need some green fuel. Wrong one would be disaster.
We don't want that to happen.
Do we even know what language we're speaking?
Belgique. So is that, do you even know what language you're speaking? I speak Geezer fluent.
What's that? pepperoni with like bread.
Crazy.
Choco, choco. Choco Lucis.
What's that?
When in Belgium. What was the Belgian chocolate?
No carp talk. What's that all about?
Dream 2075.
We have essentials. We have cappuccinos, macchiatos, smoothies, waffles, and hula hoops.
What more could you possibly want?
Maybe a big carp?
Yeah, a big carp would do me.
Big carp and a chocolate waffle.
Trolley with the
Shit, I haven't played the exit. I think I got distracted by the trolley.
Say it again now.
Joe FM.
You're listening to Joe FM. Nothing but mediocre tunes all day long. Back to back until you like it.
Hey, welcome to Belgique. Is your attrapé le grande cap?
Oui.
And the Belgique le cap, c'est bon.
Good.
So who is this geezer that we are meeting?
Ah, my friend is here.
So if you have 4 or 5 nights, I would definitely have a go here on the canal, and then maybe if you want to fish a lake. The problem is mostly this, that night fishing is not allowed, but...
No, lost one carp last night, and a couple of bide, but that was it. So, probably give it an hour or two and move on.
Daytime, don't catch me here.
Yeah.
Early in the morning, 8 at night.
Yeah.
Where do you come from, anyone in this park?
He lives in Essex. I live near Birmingham.
In Birmingham.
Last night turned into more of a social than fishing, to be totally honest. Krista Clerk and Gio from Monkey Climber both came down, live local to the area, and had some great stories over a few beers. Unfortunately, the only fish we did hook, managed to lose it. The leader actually cut through on that, so a bit gutted about that, a bit down in the dumps, but this fish has totally made up for that. Big Belgium common. £27 on the scales, fought like a demon. Have a look at that. There we go. Truly a wild fish. Made up with that. £27 is a massive fish for this water. Couldn't ask for more than that. Big thanks to Gio and Chris. All the advice, all the information. Couldn't have done it without.
There we go. Another Belgian canal common. Not quite as big this time, but still caught really hard. Same spot, same rod. Take came just as we're cooking chips and steak for dinner. So we'll get this straight back and get some grub.
Well, we have a tip section. Still got a braid.
Sudden realisation that there's about £700 of hard-earned cash sitting at the bottom of the Austin Canal.
And we... Oh, you should have set your drag tighter. That's it. Send him a text. No.
I'm shaking, man. I'm shaking.
Not the one, is it?
I mean, you always wonder on the bank when you've got a lot of kit out in front of you, you think, what am I going to do in that sort of situation? I'm going to do this and this. It's 4 a.m, it all happens so fast, and someone just runs off past your bivvy. You don't sit there and go, oh yeah, I'm going to batter him with a bank stick. It just isn't going to happen.
No.
Expand on what you've just seen on that footage. Bit of a mad one really, and we're kind of sat here trying to work out what the hell actually happened ourselves. It's like some kind of bizarre dream we've had. But yeah, to try and kind of sum it up, basically this is like 4 o'clock in the morning, so it's still dark, but you've got the kind of street lights behind us. I wake up to like a couple of beeps on the alarm. Obviously, assuming it's just a fish, open my eyes, and first thing I see is just a guy standing there holding a rod. So obviously he's come along, whether it's an opportunist kind of thing or just some geezer who's planned it, he's got my rod. First reaction, obviously shout, jump out of bed. With my rod, he throws that down the bank, and you've got kind of a drop off that's like 3 or 4 foot, and it goes down right into probably 10 foot of water. So chance of getting that back, thought time pretty slim. Start chasing him. There's another rod along the bank, which was Callum's. As he goes past that, he kind of throws that in the bank. I'm kind of stood there thinking, what the hell's going on? And he's kind of just belting off down the bank. Callum kind of wakes up as he goes by, and he's in the same, just absolute in shock of what the hell's just happened. So it's one of those things, doing stuff like this, you're fishing areas you don't know, you're obviously not local. But yeah, a bit of a reality check really, that it can be a bit dangerous, and just be prepared for it all.
We reeled in this morning quite early. We went round to Chris the Crude Swim, had a little chat with him, picked up a nice jungle CD from our new DJ friend, and now we are on our way to a little lake in Belgium. We had some amazing finkendels and some proper Belgian fries.
Yeah.
Incredible. If you come to Belgium, sample the food, very good. Between this, we've only had a couple of hours sleep, so this is going to be a kind of a new exploration for us, but also a chance to actually get our heads down for a few hours, because yeah, we're really running on fumes here. So we're currently in the car park, just a bit away from the lake we're choosing to fish. It's quite busy, and again, another one which we shouldn't be fishing. We're told there's some pretty good fish in there.
Yeah, it sounds like there's a good stock of decent fish as well, which is nice. By the sounds of it, they're kind of averaging mid-20s, that sort of size, but there's quite a few 30s and a few bigger than that as well.
But yeah, it sounds pretty savage fishing. You're kind of hiding in bushes away from obviously being spotted, and then you're fishing up to like structure in the water. So you literally hook and hold. We've been told it's going to be a case.
Jungle warfare.
Hook them, hold on, walk back, and just get them out into open water, and otherwise you're losing them. So it's going to be pretty savage fishing, to be fair. So we're just getting all.
So we're tying up rigs. Heavy duty rigs in a car park not far away from the lake. Obviously we can't tie rigs up down there because we're not even meant to be fishing, so we need to get down there
as it's getting dark, as everyone's kind of
operation diffusion camo,
as everyone's kind of petering off and getting away from the park.
Apparently there's police that come round the spotlight to check to see who's around, so
yeah, that's like midnight raid. And then got to be obviously hidden again by morning when people start reappearing. So it's going to be an interesting one, but we'll see. Hopefully sneak one or two out.
We've learned a lot about Belgian fishing. And quite a lot of it I like.
None of it's legal.
Not much of it's legal. Did you hear that? I said another one Boss out of you.
Did you?
Yeah.
No, there's been a few, but yeah, kind of situation as it stands is actually, we didn't know this was going to be here. There's a rope halfway across the lake, which kind of pretty much cuts you down to like 40 yards range. Obviously, they're using it as like lines for the swimming kind of in the lanes. I don't, to be honest, know if they're actually going to move it or not. So we're kind of waiting to see if the rangers are going to clear that out of the way. Obviously, then we can fish where we want to. But on the bright side, we have seen a couple show this side of it. But yeah, everything we've been told so far is it's at long range, as pretty much as far as you can fish on the water. But yeah, so we've seen a couple close in, so if they don't, it's not a total failure. I think we've still got a chance, but it'd be nice if they do move it and we can obviously get on the hot spots.
Last night passed quite uneventfully as the ropes never got taken out of the lake. We spent hours walking around the lake with our gear stashed in the bushes. We couldn't see any rise. We didn't see, you know, we didn't hear any splosh out.
The only ones we did see were in the area we wanted to be fishing, but obviously because of the ropes, we couldn't
reach them.
Check the area that we could fish, actually behind the ropes, and it was just so weedy you couldn't present anything.
And it was incredibly deep, which isn't really the optimum area according to everyone. So we've only had 2 hours sleep after that ordeal last night, we decided just to get some shut-eye and reevaluate the situation in the morning. This morning we've turned up what I can only describe as the Belgian triathlon. Lots of white swimming hats up and down the lake, and we seem to have timed it incredibly badly.
It's about as bad as it could get. Into speaking to people that fished it, they've never seen anything on this scale, especially with the ropes out. They've never had that problem, so I think we've picked the one time where you just physically can't fish it, but hoping that by tonight it'll all be done with. They'll took the ropes and everything away and we'll be able to fish it properly.
That's the positive from the situation. If they are finishing up tonight, then that probably will be clear. The water will probably be a little stirred up, so that could be good.
But if not, we are kind of stuck here for another night, probably fishing for not a lot of reason.
Yeah, fishing in areas which aren't good. But then again, that's fishing. There's always going to be problems, and it's all about solving them. So we're going to have a proper reconnaissance mission back round the park, see if we can't have some kind of backup plan, and take it from there, I guess.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be an easy one, is it?
No, not by a long shot, but Belgium, here we come. It's not too much to ask for, is it?
really nearly done my line here.
For a minute, as time was ticking, I really thought this park rate was going to go, no, not today, but it's one in an end. Pressure's on.
Yeah, to start with, it's just a case of locking it down, as I've seen, just walking back, just trying to get away from the danger. Hand to open water now. Hopefully. Shouldn't be too bad. Still got all the weed to deal with as well, so.
Let's see.
What happens? Big tench. Shaking its head.
It has control then.
I don't know. It doesn't feel that big, does it? See the first head down in the way. Just a little car.
It's all right, little mate.
Oh, got a bit bigger than it's got for the net. There we go. That's one in the net. Got Callum still in the sling, and there's two rods still in the water. So we'll get these weighed up, get some pictures done.
Okay, on the scales, she's gone 25 pound, absolute crazy fight. Just hooking and pumping as hard as possible to try and get it back from the spot. Yeah, 25 pound. They did say there was some lovely looking fish in here and this is exactly it. Still a bit lively as I did rush to get it in, of course. You can actually see that there's a load of brown bait in the mat, so they've definitely been troughing it. Rods are back out on the spot, but we've got to leave soon, so there is the chance of another fish, but probably not that likely.
Well, yeah, we were just saying how nice all the fish are, proper Park Lake fish these are. We were saying his looked a bit like Basil from Yateley. So if that was called Basil, this one is definitely going to be called the Fat Lady. Proper belly on it, a little bit empty, probably from spawning, and very lively. We'll rest it in the net because Callum had a take just after we'd weighed this. So he went in the recovery sling for a few minutes and he's obviously recovered.
Real odd shaped hole, this one.
Little Belgian character, that is.
So yeah, you've probably seen that as we were just doing the video of that fat fish, the 25. A couple of beaks, this rod. One rod was kind of bouncing on the tip. That didn't feel that big. Turned out to be a tench, about 8-9 pounds. Literally within 20 seconds of picking that up, the other rod went. And this one. Absolutely screamed off. Don't think it's as big. Looks a long lean fish.
Another long, lean Belgian common. really pushing the luck a bit here. Probably should have been off earlier than this. There's park starting to fill up. But not being funny, when you're catching fish like this, we'll put up with a bit of aggro if it comes. Look at that. That is the common that all commons aspire to be.
And Rich has got some aguaras.
There we go.
They took a nice photo of you.
Yeah, so I'm going to be Belgian famous.
This is what we're dealing with. Swim is an absolute carnage. Cameras, nets, rods, no rods in the water, rigs are done.
What do you think? Time to go to Holland?
That is where I go and buy my quarks. Got anything slightly racist to say?
I don't want to offend them before I even step foot in the country. To give you kind of an idea of how far we're actually going, we're kind of in Holland now. We've still got 141 miles, so proper up in the north of Holland.
Bobbing on the alarm, literally just pulled up to the blank. Hooked something, and I'm not entirely sure what it is. Not took any lime, and not really given us a lot. So it's either just a tench or something waded up, a bream, but it's just kiting out into open water. Whether it's just making use of the depth, I've not got the clutch particularly tight on there. It could quite easily be a tench, it could quite easily be a 40 pounder. I don't know, is it? I think it's just a tench. Might be just one of the small carp, because you said there's just a handful of like little stockies in here. It's like deep sea fishing. You see it appear from the murky depth. Yeah, it's a carp. Chunky one. Stop playing about, Rich. Not a bad one, actually. Sam thought it was a tench.
We've done the public lakes in Belgium, we've done the public lakes in France, and we've done the canals. And this is something totally different. We've come up to northern Holland to a lake called Carp. It's set to be the premier carp water for the country. It's got loads and loads of big fish, lovely swims, lovely location. And this is what we've opened the account with. Only the second night in. First night was a bit of a rush, getting the rods out as it was getting dark. For the second night, we sorted the spots properly, and this is a result. 44 pounds, 14 ounces. New PB for me, lovely fish. And if this doesn't make you want to come to Holland, don't know what will. So we'll get the rod back out on the spot. Hopefully, got a couple more nights here, so it should have a few more like this.
We've crushed hemp, crushed maize, some oil and some milk powder, and a load of crushed boilies into that. This ground bait could help me buy an extra bite. I've got about a kilo of bait on the spot, but I'm not convinced that anything's visited yet. I need to drag the fish down to about 5 meters, and the only way I think I'm going to do this is by adding something to the swim is to actually ball up some of this ground bait. So I'm going to give this a try over the three rods and see what happens. There we go. I'm out.
I take soul.
one was fished at some serious distance, but very close to some reeds. So the bobbin just pulled up, the tip just touched, right as we were shooting the time lapse. He's coming across the very, very deep water at the minute. He's staying really deep. Just feel a few kicks. Still a lot of line out. Okay. Staying up on the surface, mate. He's really not, like, don't want to come in.
He's a fish, he doesn't. It's simply not his job. He was just moaning a second ago that he wasn't biting.
Yeah, I was, wasn't I? Well, the revised tactics and the ground bait that I put down clearly seem to have worked, and this is the result. This was on the far rod, so it was a good distance out. Didn't fight very well until it got to the bank, and then it went a bit crazy. Definitely put a good account for itself. I'm going to get the rod back out now, position it out in the dark, but thankfully we've got the echo sounder and I know roughly where the spot is, so I should be able to get it back out.
Draait, maar op het moment dat je het opneemt, ja, gebruikt hij dus meer, hè? Dan heb je nog een uur en 40 minuten. Maar ik heb het er weer uit.
Oké, koffie is ready, guys. One of the best. I hope you like it.
Maestro.
And my left hand rod starts to pull up tight, so obviously strike into it, fish on the end, and we both end up going out in the boat. Playing this out, it doesn't feel a massive fish, but obviously want to get in the net, see what it is, and eventually Coe's nets it for us, and he's like, it's another common. Looks around the same sort of weight as well, and we're like, surely it can't be the same fish that we've had before. Once we get on the bank, we realise a little bit heavier, 24.5 pounds, I think it went in the end, but really a rare fish, and he was saying he's never seen anyone kind of catch two commons in the same session, so. As it were, we've done something a little bit special. It's not the biggest fish in the lake. There we go, cracking fish. But what's also great, you probably hear the car running in the background. Had a bit of a disaster to come to start it. We've been charging camera batteries and all sorts, and it just wouldn't start. The battery was totally dead. So the farmer came down, who lived across the way, helped us out no end, seeing us with the bonnet up, and was couldn't have been more helpful really. He's got an extension lead from his house, dragged it all the way over, charged the car for a bit, that's running now, and he's left it up here so we can charge the cameras, charge everything else we need to, so hospitality in Holland, spot on.
How does this make you feel, Carl?
A natural woman. Some people say a size 2 hook is too big. I say, take a look at this tench. Take a look at my tench. And this one is putting a real, real good scrap, even at distance.
So do we think it's a Kipposaurus?
It's got great potential. I'm not going to put a weight on it because that is fatal. Clearly just pinged off the dorsal or something like that. That sinking feeling that you get. Oh, I don't like that. Thank you.
massive, massive length on him. After that epic battle, I didn't think it was that big. Well, not this big anyway. 41 pounds, 12 ounces. An awesome looking carp. This is what Carp Lances is all about, these great big chunky mirrors. It's nice to be in the Carp Lances 40s club. A great battle. I changed rigs last night. I decided against what I was using, and it's a hard bottom out there. So I shortened the rig up, went for an inline running lead, and it's actually bagged me an extra bite. So I'm really happy actually. It's good to know that a few changes you can make could bag you an extra fish. Oh, it's getting quite heavy now. I'm gonna slip this one back. We've already got a few pictures.
Listen, Mr. Carp, what happened was perfectly natural. You wanted boilies, I wanted to catch you. Nothing's gonna change between us. No.
No, maybe we shouldn't have contact.
You should go free. Go free, Carpy. Swim off into the wilderness. You can do it. I believe in you.
Three nights in a row, just as it's getting dark and the sun's setting, we've had a bite. So I think bite time's just about the time that the sun goes down. That's resulted in this one. Again on my long range rod. I can't seem to buy a bite short range, but my long range spots are now kicking in. It's getting a steady bit of bait going in, and this one's gone 38 pounds 12 ounces. This is definitely the shortest fish we've caught, but a real heavyweight. I tell you what, it's a struggle to hold. You don't need a gym membership with these sort of fish. Big ones. Right, we're going to slip this one back.
Well, the rods are done and it's our final night on Carp Lances. We've got to be off really early in the morning, so we're not going to get early morning bite time. It's been a massive learning curve. You really have got to find your spots, and you've just got to feel the lead down and feel something that's a little bit firmer and something that's been visited. That's, I think, the key to it. First night I fished 3 meters. I didn't really have anything. Second night, Coase came round. He said, maybe try fish a bit deeper. So I found spots of between 4.5 and 5.5, and I fished those, and that's where I picked up fish from that kind of spot. You literally have to, you know, go round, find where the shelves are, and there's plenty of features to fish to. You've got 4 swims in here, and you could do 20 rods in each swim. Literally, there is so many features to fish to, and so many bars and little gullies and stuff like that. It's really good.
But yeah, keeps it interesting. But to be fair, I think with the weather as it is, it's not ideal conditions. It is varying, so we've done all right. We've managed to catch a few fish.
The pressure's been up and down. The sun's been out. The rain's, you know, come along.
English weather and kind of we brought tropical it with us, for weather. Sure. So it's been good fun. Obviously, you've had to learn late pretty quickly, but that's how it is on these venues. Most of the time, you're coming out for a week or so, and you've got to learn it from day one. So you're building up the picture as you go along. So obviously, if we come back, we've got a decent starting point, but we've managed a 40 apiece, which is kind of what we set out to do. We said if we can get a big fish from here.
The Dutch 40s club.
That's it. So, and then yeah, as you were saying, early start. Off to
Vinkenveen.
That's the one.
This should be really good.
Fishing off a boat, off the floatel. Well,
yeah, we've nicknamed this thing the floatel. It is a boat with bed chairs in, or beds in, cooking equipment and whatnot.
Yeah, so
all inside a boat.
5-star compared to what we've been used to for the last couple of weeks. So, but yeah, obviously we'll find out a bit more when we're there. But early start, get the gear loaded again, back on the road, a couple of hours drive down there, and then that's going to be final leg of the trip, so to speak. So.
We're going to Vinkenbane. Bye bye, Carplantis. Maybe see you soon.
How would you directions? Get vaguely in the area, look for some water and head that way. And we've not got to... Oh, that is a big bit of water. Whoa! Is that a sea? Yes. No? Yeah? No? Is that a sea? Or is that... Yeah, that goes into the sea. That's not what we want. We don't want the sea.
We just managed to crawl into a petrol station and on 0 miles on the fuel gauge.
Have you got a card? It's not taking mine. I don't know why.
Fuck.
Yeah.
How much have you got, mate?
About 20 euros.
Okay. We'll put 60 euros in it, if that's alright.
60?
Yeah.
Yes, okay.
Wouldn't accept our cards. It's a different shop, it turns out. This is kind of all automated. Some random Dutch guy is just sitting at the table. He was like, yes, you can buy my card, so give him the cash, helps down. Again, the Dutch have come good.
Look on the sat nav,
we're about to go over where they connect. So that's all one massive lake.
One massive lake, and then that's
is that where we're gonna be fishing?
All the lily pads and stuff.
About 5 minutes away from meeting our contact, Peter. We just went to the supermarket to pick up some stuff. What was an in-out job, and then the cards both declined, mine and Rich's card. So we had to find a cash point in a place we don't know where one is, and absolute nightmare. So we're about 40 minutes late now. I should imagine Peter's going to have the raging hump, but... I only apologise. Crazy. Everything that could go wrong has kind of gone wrong this morning. All bar the car stopping, it's all gone a bit peaked on. We're here, we're terribly late, we're terribly sorry, but we are here at last.
It's probably 80% common,
yeah.
20% mirror. We have projects in here, like in 2006 was the last time they were adding some extra mirrors.
Yeah.
And they're still growing, but some of them don't grow anymore. But there are some stunning looking fish in here.
Yeah.
But it's mostly it's common.
Yeah. Are they the kind of natural?
And
fish?
But you have like natural breeds.
Yeah.
And that will not grow up to 15 pounds. You know, very.
Long.
Very slim, very fast, very wild, and you have big comets.
Yeah.
And big comets is where we come from. Yeah.
He's gonna pull out some monsters.
This is what you're fishing with. This is what you're feeding.
Nice.
That's not on your hand. These ones will be on your hand.
Oh, nice.
Open it up, look at it. You can see it's protected hook bait and it's balanced. To make sure it's.
Yeah. That's wicked.
And that in combination with a size 2 or 4 super strong hook.
Yeah.
And a 15 centimeter
size 2
rig.
Hook.
That's what you need.
Yeah.
You got big lead with you?
Yeah.
Over 100 grams. I'm not talking ounces because I'm a Dutchman.
Yeah, 4 or 5 ounces. Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
We're at the flotel.
This is the flotel.
Please enjoy your stay. Our first night, and we've just rocked up. And we're tying two rigs in our flotel.
It's like a floating caravan, isn't it?
It is like you're in a caravan tying up rigs.
It's bizarre, but you've got miles and miles and miles of river. Or canal, or what lake?
Well, this is a lake.
Yeah, and it kind of runs. But
there's all these little islands that come off like little fingers, so it's kind of
a maze of water.
We just said to our friend Peter, who took us down here on the boat, we said it's like Holland's answer to Venice. You go down, there's houses and whatnot. It's strange.
But like the kind of gear you're using, it's hit and hold fishing. He's using kind of 25mm boilers. Hook bait is kind of it's his own concept, I think. It's like a 25mm hollowed out. It looks like a 15mm pop up inside, kind of semi like indented into it. And then he's got the shrink tube around it, so obviously the lock, crayfish, bream and stuff like that, so you want to avoid them. But he's mad for the camouflage, so they are proper riggy fish. He uses all the kind of the hit and run kind of systems where it takes 2 inches of line for every inch it takes, and they can't use a lead to eject it. He's even gone to like camo in the hook link with the weed effects type stuff, so from what he tells us, they are going to be riggy fish, so obviously we want to keep it strong but camouflage and fairly subtle at the same time, so it's a bit of a balancing act, but it looks good. We've got a couple of nights here.
Yeah, he was saying as well, £54.
Was it 54? I think it was. That was the last fish caught from this area, which is one of the massive chunks of the river. River, canal.
It's bizarre, it feels like a river or a canal. Because you're just on an arm. It's crazy.
You're on an arm.
And we've not. We've been fishing for 2 weeks, so I don't even know what country we're in. I don't know what day it is.
It is Sunday, I think. And we are in the Floatel, which is Carpy Green.
Finger bean.
Stroke the furry wall.
It's got like a little
furry wall.
Yeah.
Look at that. Caught fishing zones to Ed Sheeran.
No. Who is it?
Yeah, the Claverns.
Thank you, get it right. We're in Europe now, boy.
Sing us your song.
I have no idea what you actually sing. I've not found out yet.
What have you done?
The water's all sparkling.
What shit is that? Why? Who do that to water?
They make it sparkly. They don't drink normal water because they consider that normal people can get water that tastes good out of a tap. Which isn't in England, because water from a tap, we all know.
First world problems.
When are we going home?
2 weeks of fishing, in a small car, not a lot of sleep, finally getting to us.
Last night we put a couple of rods out. We didn't really get them spot on. A lot of things happened. The water was too cloudy to find the exact spots, and the GPS packed up working. Everything that could go wrong went wrong yesterday, but we're here. The only occurrence we had last night was a fish picked up one of Richard's lines and kited towards him, and there wasn't any drop back indication because we've had to back lead so much. Tonight we're going to try and refine all the spots, get everything spot on and, you know, hone the whole lot, change rigs, kind of worked out a little bit, so we're going to revise tactics and try and bag one, a final fish, come on.
There we go, it's the last rod out, six rods now, redone them all just as the light's going down, so hopefully a bit more of a chance. We've got GPS and everything sorted, so let's see what happens.
Last night it chucked it down with rain the whole night. We were pretty comfortable in the Floatel, but it was pretty grim outside. 3:30 in the morning, one of the rods rattles off, run out, hit it straight into the boat. Rich gets the motor started, we go right out to it. As I lift up into the fish and kind of get a proper bit of contact with it, straight away, slightest bit of pressure on it, and the leg core parts. It's a 45lb leg core, it's really thick, it's really strong. There's literally nothing you could have landed it on. It's just one of those situations. It's obviously gone over some zebra mussels or something like that, and just pretty much on the take, I guess it's almost sheared the leg core in half.
Bit of a sad way to end, really, isn't it? A lost fish, but Vinkenveen's beaten us. Started on a blank on the French public lake and finished on a blank here. But let's say we definitely caught some good fish along the way. We're on the ferry heading back to Blighty. We're going to go home, have a good shower and enjoy a few home comforts. It's been an absolutely amazing trip. I can't even begin to describe how great it's been. We've been on some fantastic venues, met some fantastic people and just really enjoyed ourselves. We've not made these videos for sponsors and, you know, to promote any tackle. We've literally just made this thing to promote carp fishing. We absolutely love it and we're going back to exactly what we started the sport for. Just going out there, enjoying it, catching fish you don't know what they are, where they live, you know, just going out there doing it. Hopefully this video has inspired you to have a European adventure and just go out there and do it. That's the best thing to do. Don't sit on Facebook talking about it, how this fish and slag people off. Just go out, enjoy your fishing and have fun.